Thank you, Jayashree, and Jayashree, for those words. Good evening, everybody. Ladies, gentlemen, drinkers, nice to see you all. I don't use the word drunkards, that's a little demeaning, so drinkers is a better word. Honestly, I was really worried what I'm going to say today because Nadija invited me and said, do the afternoon speech. I said, Nadija, you know, I've never done this. But makes you think I'm good at after dinner speech? Then she said, well, you definitely look good at dinners. Looking at you, you seem to be having a lot of good dinners. So you must be good at after dinner speeches as well. Well, I hope I prove her right. Now, I get invited a lot for these functions, but most of the work that gets given to me, ladies and gentlemen, is actually to do with after the dinner. Like, for example, my cousin got married. My uncle said, son, I want you to be there. I want you to be there and make sure that at the going away, you drive the couple home. I said, to my home? I said, no. I said, that's not, that no means driving their home. I said, okay. But I said, why that? I honestly thought that I will get invited to something like, you know, what they do where you wipe the feet of the bride room, they give you a ring. I mean, home is very wearable these years. I said, why not something like that? They said, no, son, that is too early, you know. We are not sure of your punctuality. Dinner, you will never miss. You will definitely be there. So, all the work we give you will be afternoon. So the thing is that, thank you Nadija once again for that warm welcome you gave me and also the invitation. But I'm very confused after my own introduction. Let me tell you why. Ladies and gentlemen, I am Tharindu Amarasena. No problem. Wait, it is a problem. Because you introduced me as Tharindu Abhaysekar. That's it. My name is Abhaysekar. Now I'm really, really worried about that. You know, because what you did just there. You know, I'm really shocked. I need to go back home and speak to my parents tonight. Sorry?
Nadija is not my basic.
Okay. Right. And I know all the history of everyone, so can trust him on that. By the way, I'm sure all of you had to endure the corona lockdown. Yes, you were at home. What do you think about the corona time? Wonderful, isn't it? Yes. Yes. Toastmasters ended up realizing that we are also good listeners. Right? That we had to listen to everything that... I was at home. I had to listen to my mother, right? And after doing that for so many months, I realized what a great man my father is. Because it's just amazing, you know. I mean, what I did for 3 months, he's been doing for the last almost 45 years. That's just absolutely fantastic. I know this video is being recorded. I haven't been in that part of before it goes live. Also, you know, husbands ended up realizing that they are very good at cooking, scraping coconut. One of my friends said, the first day of office after the lockdown, he went and sat on his chair and automatically it came from his inner self. Forget ekak gana, dekak gana. So anyway, people are staying fit. People who never ever even think of exercising were what? Doing a lot of workouts, at least for the sake of social media. Right? At least for the sake of social media, they were doing so many workouts. It's good. I think it's fantastic. Now, you are probably thinking, Tharindu, didn't you do any workouts? Right? How about you? Well, I didn't. Right? Let me tell you why. I realized the importance of staying like this way back in 2010 in England, where I was walking on somewhere around London, and there's this group of people who came in all of a sudden, mobbed us, myself and a few other people who were there, and said, oh, we are raising money for the poor children. Let's please donate money. And minimum donation amount, that is the worst part, was £10. And then somebody asked them, oh, which kids are you helping? They said, oh, we are helping the kids who don't have food to eat. From which country, someone asked. They said, oh, countries like Sri Lanka. And all of a sudden, one people, we were all in a tour, we were trying to get on to this London night. Somebody said, wait a minute, wasn't there some kid from Sri Lanka? And here I was. Right? They were like, he's from Sri Lanka. How come there are kids without food? But that lady was smart. The donor, the ones who were raising funds were very smart. She was probably a better improper speaker than I am. She said, well, he's probably eating all the food, that's why the other kids are not fed. It's tough life, but yes. So, friends, now, we being in Toastmasters, we all the time we look at having speech craft programs. But I think we always look at the corporate crowd for having speech craft programs. We should look beyond that. Why not cricketers? Now, let me see the fans of cricket. Well, maybe one person there, very good. Two, three. Your favorite cricketer? Sangakkara. Out of the current lot? Sri Sangakkara. Busan Wendy's, all right, we know Busan Wendy's fan. Yeah, I think that's fantastic. All right, let me ask you, okay, all the Sangakkara fans, what's your, what, I'll come to you later. No, the light will be on you a little bit, but all the Sangakkara fans, out of all these knocks, what's your favorite? Out of all these innings, what's your favorite? Let me ask you.
Partnership with
Mahendra. You are probably one mutual friend, right? No. In cricket, the one in Lords. The one in Lords.
Partnership with Kumar Dharmasena. The match we lost in South Africa, which we should have won.
Oh, yes, the one that the century was almost there. Makai and Pini and BW. I remember. Yes. I didn't do my homework that day because I was so angry. Now, coming back to him, Kusan Wendy, right? Sir, what about you? What's your favorite knock out of his, all his innings? The one in Panadra, don't tell me the knock in Panadra. That's not a knock we want to talk about, isn't it? Well, there's a lot of talk going about that, isn't it? Well, I think that's proved that he's very consistent because he handled that case just like how he handles cricket, out quickly, right? That's all we can say. But honestly, I think we should also look at doing a Toastmasters like a speech class session for cricketers because there's a very famous cricketer, right? I don't want to really mention any direct names because it's not nice. He mentioned Busan Wendy, it's not me. But right, this cricketer is obviously associated with a lot of things like very fast knocks, hard hitting, orange juice, right? So there's a lot of, he's associated with a lot of things like that. Nothing I can see or regret the fact that you invited me for this thing, right? But so the thing was that this cricketer used to get interviewed because during his time, ladies and gentlemen, we actually won cricket matches, right? I mean, now winning against Afghanistan is a great thing. I remember there was milk rice made at my house the next day. I'm like, what happened? We won a match against England? No, okay, we won that too, but still. Australia, no, who? Afghanistan. Never mind. But this cricketer used to get interviewed very often, after winning. So, and he had a standard answer, no matter what question was asked. All right? And the question, and always, they would ask, oh, so congratulations on winning. What are your thoughts? He was like, oh, you know, credit should go to the boys, especially Sangha and Mahendra did a tremendous effort and fantastic. All the boys did well, bowlers bowled well, fielders of India. And last minute things were difficult, but Murali went in and got out of the situation. Because that was the time that Murali, Sangha, Mahendra would always give us a match. Sadly for him, one day, they asked, congratulations, so and so, we heard your wife delivered a baby this morning, congrats. Oh, credit should go to the boys, they made it, especially Murali and Sangha Mahela Devi, they are best. Things were difficult in the last moment, but went in and got us out of the difficult situation. So, I think we definitely need to have Toastmasters even for cricketers. Let's improve them. You know, after all, they go up there, they represent us. A bit of decent English is not too much to ask, you know, after all. What about the parliament? I was told no topics are, you know, off limits tonight. So anyway, why not a Toastmasters speech class program for the parliament, ladies and gentlemen? I mean, they have enough money to spend, our money, but still, they have enough money to spend, yes? But just imagine you do a speech class session for parliamentarians.
That's the end of Toastmasters.
That's the end of Toastmasters. Could be, you never know. But not these days, because these days everyone is being very nice. I got a call today from one of the contestants' office today, right? Obathuma, Kulamba district. Whoa. Obathuma, I don't know other about some person. First name is Uday, and there are a lot of people in Uday, so I talked at that. I said, Oya Kanath Kondala Dano, I had a case, but I didn't know that Usagi. Then, sir, Ekamana Halasar Kiyama, I mean, she has not called me yet. I'm waiting for call. Sweet voice, I like that. But nevertheless, imagine you do a speech craft session for Toastmasters. For parliamentarians, right? Just imagine what can happen, ladies and gentlemen. Right? You have a R counter, right? You have a R counter. But this won't go for too long. I know speech craft sessions can go for very long. Not if you do for the parliamentarians. So you have imagine you appoint a famous former president as the R counter. What will happen? After the meeting, he gets up. And then immediately you'll have another former prime minister saying up. Now these Toastmasters must be done in English. Why is the R counter speaking in Tamil? This is not acceptable. What about Toastmaster of the day? Please. Right? you get the then you will also find the toastmaster of the league, right? Who has been appointed by the current president, right? Well, that is the word these days. So he's appointed by the current president, and the toastmaster day or first toastmaster of the day will be like, Parajati inge me kumantrama tekkena toastmaster sage Lankawen thuran karanna ona. And you will also get the normal members who come for the sandwiches and the cutlets, my friends, like me. I mean, I'm sure you can say, you can see that. I knew Lions Toastmasters was also a very nice meeting to attend, because I walked into the room and there was chicken keys. You know, I never had chicken keys in a Toastmaster event in my life before. So, congrats on that. Tamil, I know you enjoyed it as well. You dropped all the chicken keys on your body that day. So, but yes, you get the normal Toastmasters who will get up and say, put up, put up, put up. In English. මේ සිංහල කතා අපි විතරයි කල්ජයක් කතා කරන්නේ ඒක නම් තුන තමයි ඉතුරු වෙන්නේ මෙදාපාරේ තුනක් නැති වෙයි වගේ යන so as a result I really don't see a toastmaster initiative for a speech craft program for these parliament meetings going very far so ladies and gentlemen they say an after dinner speech is supposed to be a laughing matter for me When somebody says that person is going to speak after laughing, that is the laughing matter, right? Because who wants to listen to speeches while having dinner after dinner? But I hope I was able to do some justice to my presence today, and I need to really get back home and speak to. I have a heart-to-heart chat with my parents and uncle Abhay Sekar after what. Thank you very much, and have a good day.